is to our God. Hey, this is what I love.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Every praise is to our God. You know, sometimes we are going through our situations and we don't know where to turn. But this morning, I want to encourage you. It's those moments when we don't know what to do that we ought to lift our hands and we ought to praise God, because it's in our praise that situations change and things happen. This morning, I want to encourage you to come on and praise the Lord with me.
Look into our chat right now, God. Look into our chat right now, God. And minister to Julia, minister, oh God, to Leah, minister, God, to answer, meet those prayer requests in the name of your precious son, Jesus. God, you are great, God. You are mighty, God. You are awesome, God. Church, I want you to go expecting what we have prayed for, looking for what we have prayed for. Hallelujah. Looking, Matthew and John, God, go expecting. We don't take prayer lightly. We don't just put on a show. We put these needs before God, and then we go looking to see God answer these prayers. And then we have testimony, and then you come back and testify, because God did it in the Old Testament. He did it in the New Testament. And we know that God is doing it today. God is still meeting needs today. So when you come back and testify and share how God has come true for you, it shows the person that are listening on. It isn't that we read it in the Bible. Look, we read it in the Old Testament. Look, we read it in the New Testament. But look, it is recorded today that God taught Sister Hortense. It is recorded today that God taught Sister Aline. It is recorded today that God taught the Sonia's family. It is recorded today that God touched Brother Irwin and family. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Brother Clark testifying all the time, God is keeping me. Some old person could say, he's all over me and he's keeping me alive.
Because all we want, it's for him to be glorified and be lifted up in our lives. Hallelujah. Let's praise him this morning.
Sing to you. Praises from the inside. From the inside. Inside of me, 'cause all I
For you to be glorified, you to be lifted high, God. Praise is written for you, O God. And to you the vow shall be performed. O you, God, who hears prayer, to you all flesh, all of us run to God. Bless your wonderful name. Hallelujah. All I want, Lord, is for you to be glorified, not about me. It is for you, God, to be lifted high, not about me. It is for you, God, to receive all the honor and all the glory. Father, we lift those on this chat and these households and these families before you. God, may they receive your word even though we have come with our cups upturned. Fill them, God. Touch Sister Mary, God, as she ministered to us. In Jesus' name, we pray with thanksgiving. Amen and amen. Our speaker this morning is Sister Cyralene Mary. One from among us, powerful woman, one who loves God with all of her heart and has a passion for the things of God and to see persons saved and come to know Jesus Christ and walk in the purpose that God has called us to. Sister Mary, your congregation, may God bless you as you share it with us.
A blessed good morning to you, Pastor. A blessed good morning to the family of God. And we welcome all our visitors to this Zoom platform. All we want this morning is for God to be glorified. We want God to be glorified from Bathsheba to Boston, from Rhema, my dear, all the way to Wright's Village. We want God to be glorified from Carrington Village to Canada. Wherever there's a human being who has breath this morning, we invite you to praise our God. We thank God for this opportunity where we can connect as a family of God. And God is on this platform this morning with a purpose. This platform is saturated by the Holy Spirit. God has got a divine appointment this morning and he's in the house to do something specific. He gave me a word, and this word is a word from God directly to you. It's a simple word for a complex situation. All around the world, people are concerned now about pandemic. People are fearful. The Spirit says to me that people are losing sleep. People are anxious. The word of God comes to you this morning from Psalms chapter 37. Psalm 37 verse 5 is the word of God to everyone who's listening this morning and those who will listen afterwards by the tape. It says, "Commit thy way unto the Lord. Trust also in him, and he shall bring it to pass." Commit thy way to the Lord. Don't matter what is happening, God is saying to you, commit your way to the Lord. Trust also in him, and he shall bring it to pass. This is a word that comes for everyone, whether you're a believer or an unbeliever at this time. I had such wonderful news whilst we were in the prayer session this morning. Something I've been praying for, somebody I committed to God, and God has already brought them home. The person know what I'm talking about. Whilst I was worshiping my father was shown to me that his word is true. Commit thy way. And when we say thy way, we mean everything that touch and concerns you. Everything that touch and concern you, touch and concerns God. Commit it to God. There are no secrets you cannot share with God. He says, commit thy way. Do you know what commit means? Commit means to submit. It's like you're going to the bank. You go to the bank and you submit your money to the bank. You don't go back every morning, I hope, trusting and checking to see if it's there. I hope you're not online every minute to make sure money is still in your account. No, because you've committed it. You have submitted it to the bank. And you know once you put it there, you should get the interest they promised. God is saying, do the same thing with me, children of God. Those who don't know me, I'm a God that can be trusted, he says. Have you not heard? Have you not seen that the everlasting God, the creator of all the earth, he is somebody you can trust this morning. This morning, God is asking us to commit everything to him. He says some of you are going and you're depositing it with him, but then you're going and you're doing your withdrawals. It's like when I was a child, something I did, and my sisters are probably on the line so they can confirm it. My mom used to have bread and she would do it in the dough and she would put the yeast in it and she would put it aside just to leave it alone so it could rise. I, the little wicked one, would go and poke my finger in them. By the time she gets back, every single bit of bread that she thought was going to be risen was flat. God is saying, you're doing the same thing. You've given it to me. I am working it out for you. Because the word says, commit thy way unto God and he shall bring it to pass. I mean, he will work it out. But some of you are like me. You're going out poking your finger in it. And then you cannot understand why it is collapsing. When God says commit, he means turn the thing entirely over to this person. That's when you commit your life. If you're a married person, you understand me. You turn your heart over to a person because you entrust them with it. You know that they will care for it. How much more our Father God is saying to us this morning, commit thy way. Everything that concerns you, commit your time, commit your troubles, commit your talents, and commit your treasures. This morning, Dr. Jesus is in the house, and he is doing what I call a CT scan. Do you know a CT scan are one of those things where you have an X-ray and it's called a computed tomography? And those of you who are nurses and doctors here on the line know what I'm talking about. It is a kind of X-ray that has multiple levels. It looks into the body. And when it looks into the body, it can diagnose what is going on in there without them having to cut you, without them having to have surgery. But God is in here today doing a CT scan. He's saying, we are here, and this is my appointment with you, a divine appointment. And I want to see, are you see? Are you committed? Have you committed things to me? And the T, are you trusting me? Are you leaving things with me and knowing that I will work it out? This week, I'll say this to you. We have to, this word is a word you have to put in action. I've had conditions this week where I was in an interview, and I interviewed with 5 persons. And these persons were coming at me left, right, and center. At one point in time, I had to turn my Zoom mic off and my camera off because a tear came down my eyes because I'm like, Lord, so much pressure is coming on. But then I remember the words of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. And I remember the words they said to Nebuchadnezzar. They said, oh, Nebuchadnezzar, we have no need to answer you because they had their confidence in God. And instead of responding, I went quiet. I went quiet because I know I had prayed and I had put this in God's hand. And no matter how it is looking like now, how under so much pressure, I trust my God. And I will tell you, this is a true report. I did not have to say anything in the matter. By the end of the interview, the praises that were being showered on the child of God for how she's handled things and her accomplishment, it blew my mind because when I went in, it looked like trouble was in every hand.
Hallelujah.
I want to say to you this morning, this is a God that can be trusted. And when I say that everything that touch and concern you, leave nothing out. Don't leave out your time. Commit your time to God. Every day when you wake up, your plans for the day should be committed to God. Lord, thy will be done. You should be saying like Mary did, oh, be it unto me according to thy word. You're supposed to be reading in the mornings and meditating on God and then committing your day to God and say, God, let it work out according to your word. This is a CT scan this morning and God is checking, are you really fully committed? He showed me in the spirit that there's some of you who are tossing and turning at night. You are worried about your children. Come on, come on, come on. We are the children of God. Do we know our scriptures? You remember the scripture in Romans chapter 8, verse 38 to 39. You are supposed to say, for I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate me, those I love, those that touch and concern me, shall ever be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus, bought, paid for, sealed, signed, and delivered. This morning, God is saying to you, commit your life and everything that concerns it to me, and you watch me work. Then some of you are concerned about trouble. Some of you think, I have health problems, Sister Murray. And every time the shoulder pains, I hear what my Sister Sabrina, I give another testimony here. I had a shoulder that I could not move. They had a fancy word, a locked shoulder. They said to me, oh dear, you're gonna have to have therapy. I went for the first therapy session and I said, 2 more of these, I'll be broke. I will be so broke because of the cost of them. But I put it to Jesus. And I had a little friend told me, take your hand and put it against a wall and crawl up that wall with your hand up and down as exercise. And I can tell you today, my hands and my shoulders are working in Jesus' name. Commit everything to God. The word says, commit thy ways to God. Trust also in him and he worketh. The Amplified Bible says that he worketh. He delivers this morning. I'm not telling you about something that I don't know. This is a God that we have tried. And I know Pastor Lavia, and I know Pastor Belgrave. I know Sister Roberts. I know Sister Beth. I know Sister Tony, Sister Rosam, Raul Eastman, Brother Raul. I can tell, we can testify of a God who we've tried him over and over and over again. And he's delivered. Let me tell you, this word of God gets me so excited. That's something I have to slow down because it is so sweet to me. This word of God is my vehicle. Wherever I have to go, it takes me. This word of God is my towel. When my tears are coming down my eyes, it comforts and it wipes them away because I trust in him. Oh, there, it is my covering. Don't care how hot it gets, the sun, he said, the sun shall not smote thee by day, nor the moon by night. That's what my God promised me. When I need a counselor and I need to have a direction to go, because I've committed my life to God, he says to me, and you will hear behind you a voice which say, this is the way, walk ye in it. This is the God we're talking about this morning. This is your CT scan. Are you committed to God this morning? Have you submitted everything over to him? And are you trusting in this God that you know? Listen to this one. He promised us in Deuteronomy chapter 33, verse 25. That was when there was a blessing being given to Asher. And this blessing that was given to him is a blessing which is to us this today. The blessing at the end of verse 25 says, as your days, so shall your strength be. Do you hear that one? As your days, so shall your strength be. Which means do not worry about tomorrow. Whatever the day's events that unfold today, God has got you equipped for it. Do you hear me? Do I have an amen? Is there anyone who will give an amen?
Amen.
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 Yes. Amen. When we've gone through sorrow and grief, amen. I've had the experience of having my sister die in my hands. And if you told me I would be able to be saying now, when at 14 years old, a 10-year-old die in my hand and there's no adult around, many thought I would have gone crazy. But I knew my God from a teenager, young pre-teenage. And he promised, as your days, so shall your strength be. Child of God, those who don't know our God this morning, he can be trusted. Do not worry about the future. When you get there, oops, God already is there. Do not worry at the past. He has already washed that away if it was dirty and he's made it clean. Just look forward, being confident of this one thing, that he who has started a good thing in you is able to do what? To perform it. He is able, well able. And listen to this word of God. This word of God, young people, this morning is not like your words. You know, Samari tries to keep up with the young people. So I'd be using words like, oh, it is lit. Then Adriana said to me, mommy, we're not using that word anymore. That word is kind of stale. Whenever I get a word, I'm rolling on the floor laughing, F-O-L-L, they tell me, we don't use that anymore. So I can't keep up with the young people word. But the word I'm giving you today is a word from everlasting to everlasting. My grandfather passed, Reverend Taylor and his wife trusted in it. My father and my mother trusted it. My sisters and my brothers trusted in it. This is a word that stays forever the same. This is a God who, when he spoke, he had nobody else that he could confirm it with, and he confirmed it by himself. This morning, the call of God to everyone who's listening is commit your life to me, commit your ways to me, and trust in me, and I shall perform it. Let me hurry along. This morning, the four things we are going to commit to God. First of all, he says, before you do anything in your life, you should consult me. Young people, you hear me. Older people, you hear me. Middle-aged, you hear me. Before you embark on anything in your life, you should consult God. He is expecting that you will speak to him and all the plans are worked out together. Remember, he is the one who has the recipe for this master cake. He is the baker. He is the maker. He has the recipe. Do not go like I did once when my mom told me to put in baking powder in the sweet bread when I live in Canada. And I say baking powder, baking soda, same thing. When I smell the thing boiling over in the oven, I could barely, the alarms in the apartment in Canada were going off because the baking soda had the thing floating, sister. Stop laughing, Sister Best. It was going over and over. And when I tasted a little bit that I rescued, it was so bitter. That is because I substituted something that person who gave the recipe did not tell me to do. When you commit your way to the Lord, it means you follow his guidance. Do you hear me? Amen. He's got the recipe. He's got the road map, and it is not difficult. Let me pause and tell you, do not believe those people who say that the Christian walk is so difficult. That is not true. I have found it to be sweet because I always have a companion that walks with me. I am telling you, there are some nights I am telling you when things come to me and I have to work them out for the next day. And in the middle of the night, I find, look, I can't sleep. Then I turn to my friend and say, look, over to you. Like I teach my daughter, we have a saying, off to Jesus. Anything that comes and it wants to make me uncomfortable, look, off to Jesus. Meaning I turn that over. Now, who else in life has somebody like that unless they have Jesus? A constant companion. Because let me tell you, my mother has died, was my friend gone. Father's died, was my friend gone. I had other friends. I remember Sister Lynette this week, the people who have just gone. But the one constant person you have from now through eternity is Jesus Christ himself. Amen. How could you not have a blessed life? He has. Hallelujah. I'm like Peter. I said, Lord, who else can I go to? For you have the words of eternal life. Everything is taken care of. Amen. Must know that once you committed, yes, Sister Cheryl, Lord, Sister Annie, I remember you all when I do my prayer. And when I pray, I said, for I am persuaded. Bless the Lord, Brother Akil. Bless the Lord, Brother Kyle. There are people I've committed unto God. And I say, for I am persuaded that he's able to keep that which I've committed unto him against that day. I do not walk by sight. That's what God said to us. Don't walk by sight. Walk by faith. And faith is that trust. I commit it and I trust him. You know, there's a scripture that says, it's in the Psalms. Let me see if I could find it here for you. It's one of my sweet ones. So I want to give it to you. Let me find it and give it to you. It says, I will lay down and sleep in peace. Do you all know that one? I will lie down and sleep in peace. If you don't know it, let me find it for you. I have to tell you that Psalm 4:8. I know them so well. I don't memorize the scripture. See, I apply the scripture. So I stiff the peace I want and I just hold on. And I just hold on to it. I just know it's in the Bible. I may not remember the exact chapter and verse, but I saw it there and it's in my heart now because that's where he told me to write it, on the table of my heart. It says, I will lay down, Psalm 4:8. And sleep, not just sleep, but sleep in peace. Why? For you alone, you hear that? You alone, our God, make me dwell in safety. If you don't know God this morning, I am recommending, look, he comes so highly recommended by me. I will write a reference for him, a testimonial. I will turn up in person and speak to you and tell you about this person. I will want to tell you, oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man and the woman and the young person that trust in him. So this morning, God wants you to consult him. I remember, and I have this note of caution. And you know, I talked to him, speaking to you is how I talked to my daughter. Probably not so invigorated, but I say this to her. I gave her this scripture, and the scripture says like this, Isaiah chapter 30, verse 1 and 2a. It says, woe unto anyone who carry out plans that are not mine. They go down to Egypt without consulting me. Woe to anyone who carry out plans that are not mine, who go down to Egypt without consulting me. You hear that? God, you know what woe means? Everybody know what woe means. We just go like, ha ha, it's a beige and ha ha. For anyone who does that. So when I say to commit your way to God, you got to consult God and you talk to him and pray. And young people say, but Sister Mary, how you know if it is God who answers you back? Well, you got to know the word. You know how you recognize somebody's voice. I live in my home here. If somebody comes at my door and said, open inside, I know if that's my husband's voice or not. You know why? Because I've heard his voice before. And I will say, sound your voice again. So sometimes I say to God, Lord, if that is you, I'm like Gideon, I put up my fleece. If this is what you really want me to do, to leave this job and go to another, give me another sign, Lord. That's the relationship you build with God. And then you kind of know that that's my father because it's lining up with his word. Because I know his word and that is lines up with his word. I've had some young person say to me, but Sister Mary, this person I'm really attracted to. and the person liked me really bad, but they're not yet divorced. I would say, well, that in the word of God, you don't even have to come to me. You cannot be involved. That is not
Amen.
God speaking. God is not going to tell you to interfere with something which he said no man shall put apart. So do not get involved with that. But you got to know your word of God so you can consult him. The next thing, quickly as I go, when you commit, you have to be able to confide in God, tell him your secrets. Listen, the thing is, God know about me. That if you all know, you all would unfriend me. That's what they do on Facebook. You all would unfriend me. But I can share my secrets with God. Not so, Sister Lavia. I share things with God. I don't have to, people I have to hide my PIN number from when they go in the supermarket, so don't steal it. You got to keep your identity so people don't steal it. But with God, I can tell him everything about me. Because guess what? He already knows.
Amen.
But he's just waiting to see if I'm going to admit it. The word this morning from God, commit everything. You want a boyfriend, you have debts that seem that you can't get them paid, commit it to the Lord and go sleep. Do you hear me? Sister Mary will tell you this, and I give you another testimony because my God is real. I had the word of God came to me and it said to me in my ear, I want you to start every month. I don't care what you do. You know, tithes first. But after that, I want you to start putting aside something. I don't care what bills you say, all the things you have to do, start putting aside something. And moving out on the word of God, I cut cloth. You know how you say I have to cut the cloth a little tighter now? Because I heard from God. Let me tell you about how sweet my Father is. It was not even 6 months good. An opportunity presented itself. And because I had a whole, I can say, whopper ton of money put aside, I had a whopper ton of savings, that I got a blessing. And the blessing only came. And when you all fell in front of what you all going to share, I can't tell you all now because we have visitors here and I don't know them all. But when I tell you the blessing that God gave me, it is because I heard a voice speaking. And this voice told me to do this. And I did it. I did not know what was coming down the road, but I committed it to God. I trusted it and it worked out something for me. This is a spectacular blessing. And let me tell you, Sister Mary's not doing because he has no favorite children. I am undone like you. I was born in sin, shaped in iniquity, but I accepted the Lord Jesus Christ as my Savior as a young person. And I'm telling you, he's been my companion from then until now. And everybody else could leave. But one person I must have Jesus go with me. So you confide, don't only consult, confide in him and he will bring things to pass for you. Then the other thing I want to say to you, you got to cooperate with God. Work with God. When God said, don't do something, don't do it. You hear me? When God says, don't do something, don't try to take matters into your own hands. The word of God has given us examples of people who went helping their husbands out, send the wife in, send the handmaiden into the husband because God had given them a promise and caused so much trouble all the way down to this day and age because she could not wait on God and the promise that God gave to Abraham. She was helping out God. I have learned this. And some of my people who know me, my friends on the platform, they know I'm like this. If I do not hear from God, a sister knows I say that, what has God said? If I do not hear from God, I am not doing anything. I am not doing it. I am not moving. I am staying there. I am like Moses. Lord, unless your presence go with me, I beg and I ain't going away. I ain't going away. I don't care what they say. I am not going anywhere because I cooperated with God. You know, like, you know, have some people say to you, I want you to come by me. And I tell them, I'm all the way in St. Philip. The best way to come is Highway 5. No, they're following GPS. Now, the GPS is going to carry you through some chaotic roads because the GPS person is obviously not Barbadian. And there's some the way up in somebody's fowl farm, somewhere up in Bel Air, and going to say to me, oh, I can't get through because you did not cooperate. I told you, come up Highway 5, come straight up. You go on money GPS. How many of your friends have been the GPS that you're following? How could you commit your way to God? He's giving you direction. Then a GPS, a girlfriend whose position isn't even sacred. That's a GPS. And you're following this person when God has given you direction. My heart blessed me this week when I got a recording from Brother Roy Eastman and his wife and his grandson. And I saw the direction that that family is taking that young man. They're teaching them about God's ways and how to follow God's ways. That song blessed me all week. I sang that song to myself. And I'm saying, because we're teaching our children, you got to cooperate and work with God. I will hasten to close shortly. So the C is when you commit, you've got to cooperate, you've got to consult God, and you've got to make sure you confide in God. And then you do it of your time, all your time, your talents, and all your energies. You are supposed to commit to God. And let me tell you something as well. I have seen God turn so many things around. And that's why I can testify about him this morning. And I'm going to close with this testimony. I shared it with some of you guys, all you may have heard. I had a loved one. Yes, Sister Bess. I had a loved one. Yes, Sister Tony. Who I got the news. I was beginning to feel like Job. One call came through. This one has COVID. I said, we're lost, Lord. Over to you, Lord Jesus. I can't deal with that one. Next call come through. Oh, shoot, the husband have it too. Oh, I said, Lord, it's coming in. Before that done good, I heard they've gone to Black Mongolop. I said, Lord, at least they go in there. They'll get care. Another call came just before, like 9 o'clock in the night. This one has made a turn for the worse. So they're rushing them in a hurry. They're going down to the fireplace, what they call it now, all the way down St. Lucie. You all know what I mean.
Harrison Point.
And they've gone down to Harrison Point. Then I heard the next news came on the ventilator. And I said to myself, no devil in hell not going to scare me. I'm committing this to God. And I had a set of prayer warriors. And we were singing in the midnight hour. I called the wife and said, don't worry, you're on the ventilator. Stop watching CNN. And all those who say that once in a ventilator, they hardly ever come off. Those are the ones who we have not committed to God possibly, or the ones that God was ready for. But unless God is ready for this person, my praise will make a difference. And we prayed and we prayed. And none, two are down. Then I got another call. Guess what? The van coming for another one. I said another one, another household. Well, this is crazy. And as the news came, and I had at one point, I had four. And I said, dear Father, Lord, what over to you. And I was singing like Paul and Silas. And my family said, you know, like I'm singing, I'm calling, I'm singing. I said, God has got this. Let me tell you how fantastic a God that I'm telling you to commit yourself to and to trust today. The one that was on the ventilator, he turned in the night. No, he got up in the morning and he called up and said, guess what? The nurse came in the night and took off the ventilator when I was sleeping. And I breathed like normal. And I said, praise the Lord, my God is working. But I got a call a few minutes more later. He called back and said, the nurse said, wait, who took off your ventilator? You still supposed to be on that? I said, but the Lord went in the midnight hour and let you know, like Paul and Silas, your breath is okay. And he has been breathing good since then. There is nothing I want to tell you too difficult for my God. Amen. Every single one of them has come out. Don't ever doubt God. Then I have persons who are concerned about the vaccine this morning. You pray before and you ask God, should I take it? And once Father God confirmed to you, go forth with no fear. Commit it unto God. Trust in him. And I promise you, my God will work it out. So are you persuaded this morning? Father said to me, there's some of you who made deposits with him, but you know who you are. You went and you took them back out. And you have the deposit holding on your mattress, which means at night you worry about them. He's saying to you, the bank is open. It's open again today. Recommit it to God. The child, the husband. Listen to this one. Women of God who are wives. How come your husband is not just committed to God and leave it there? Stop interfering with the work of God. Your ways are not his ways. His ways are so high above yours. But he has a way of working it out. Trust him.
Amen. Amen.
Trust him this morning. Young person, you're making plans for your life. There's so many big plans you have. Let me tell you something that I have learned. You can have success in life, but it's not good success. Do you hear this, old lawyer here? You can have success in life, but if you want good success, commit your plans to the Lord. Discuss them with God. Make sure they align with God. And a success that he gives you will bring you no sorrow. Do you hear me? There's a success that brings you sorrow, sleepless nights, concern. But if you commit it to God, consult and confide in him your time, your talents, and your energy, he will give you a good expected end. But then I know I have persons who are on, and you've never trusted God. Listen to this one. The first commitment you have to make is to give him your life. Give God your life. And it's a good thing to give your life to God. And it's easy, you know. You don't have to sort out things first. I've had young ladies who say to me, I got to sort it out. A young man, I have to sort it out first and then come to God. Who crazy person does wash the clothes by hand and then go and put them in the washing machine? No, we take the clothes dirty as they are and we put them in the washing machine and the washing machine does the washing. Consider the Holy Spirit and God this morning, your washing machine. Come as you are, dirty as you feel, undone as you are, because the Father God will clean you up and he'll make you exactly what he wants you to do to be.
Amen.
And he will do it for you in
Amen.
In Jesus' name. So let us pray now. Now this is the time we call it, this is time with God. Now you had an appointment with God and these appointments are divine. If you know this morning, and we're doing it in the chat is so lovely because in the chat, we can do private messages to Pastor Lavia, to Pastor Belgrave. Nobody has to see. If this morning you've never trusted God and you know your life is not working out like you want it to, or you have not trusted God, but you think your life is going to work out, but you heard this preacher lady who said to you, it don't work so. You cannot have a life independent of God and be successful. And if you want to trust God this morning, you can send a message to any of us in the chat and say, pray for me. I want to accept Jesus because we are willing to pray with and for you. This is what this is about, a commitment to God. Wherever you are, whatever you're going through, you have a God who can help you. And that is for those who don't know our God. But maybe you are a child of God and you know you've been worrying. You're worrying about the mortgage, you're worrying about the children, you're worrying about the food, you're worrying about the money. Come on, you're a child of God. This morning, let us repent. Let us tell our God that we are sorry. Say, Father, so we can say to the Lord, we forget who you are and whose we are. If you want to repent this morning and pray to God that he would forgive you and that you want to turn everything back over to him this morning, be in the chat again. Or not, you can wave. There's a reaction button where you can put a thumb up, put your hand up, do a hand clap, do anything and send a sign to us. We want you to pray for us. And let your prayer be, Lord, I give up the struggle. To thee, I commit my way. I trust your word forever and settle it all today in Jesus' name. If you're one of those persons, I have the time. We have the time. And we're waiting for you in Jesus' name. Yes, Pastor. Yes, our pastors, we are vigilant. We are looking in Jesus' name. Commit your way to God. Trust all in him in Jesus' name. Yes, Sister Lavia.
Right ahead. Sister Alicia is requesting prayer. Do we have anyone else on the platform who needs prayer this morning?
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, yes, I see Brother Roll.
Maybe you're worried about something. Yes. Just let us know that we can pray for you. I see Caroline Han. Her hand is up. We're going to pray for you. Praise God. Praise God. Is there anyone else? Praise God. I see that hand. Praise God, Sister Christy. Praise God. I see that. And God sees all of the hands that are up this morning. Praise God. If you're needing prayer, if you need help, hallelujah, praise God. Sue, I see that hand. Praise God. Sister Julia, I see that hand as well. Just place your hand up, hallelujah. God, praise God, simply blessed. God sees those hands, hallelujah, praise God. Praise God, Chanel. Yes. Praise God.
Jesus.
God sees, and we are going to pray. Hallelujah.
Yes. And dear Sister Lavia, let them know that God is waiting, you know. God is waiting. God has a purpose for this morning. Hallelujah. God says to me, he knows what is coming this week. He knows the things that are going to secure the life out of some of you guys, and he wants to have you ready that you came this Sunday and you committed it to God and don't care what happens. God says to me to say to you to remember this good old word in Hebrews chapter 11, verse 6, and I'm going to go over the Spirit. He said that those who come to God must believe that he is, and that he's a rewarder of those who diligently seek him.
Amen.
And if you're seeking God this morning, no, God's going to bless you. If you raise your hand, if you recommit your life and everything that touch and concern you to God this morning, know that our God is watching. Know that he is watching every hand that is raised. And we, the people of God, we are going to pray for you in Jesus' name. Yes,
amen.
Yes,
praise God. Praise God. We also want to encourage you, if you don't know Jesus Christ as Lord, don't put it off today. Today is the day of salvation. Praise God. He has not given you tomorrow. So if you need him in your life today, hallelujah, we are going to pray the prayer of salvation for you. Praise God, that you will accept him in your life today. Commit yourself to him. Commit your ways to him. We have heard the word. This is such a timely word. With all that is happening around us, we need to commit ourselves to the Lord and let him direct our pathway. Hallelujah. Let him take the days ahead, the months ahead, the years ahead, because he is ultimately in control. So before we pray this morning, if you're needing Jesus in your life, put your hand up right now. Hallelujah. God sees that hand and he is looking for you. His eyes are on you this morning. Praise God. We are going to pray right now. Hallelujah. Praise God. Father, you see all the hands that are up right now. Oh, Holy Spirit, go into those homes right now in the name of Jesus. And Lord, take care of that one. Hallelujah. You said, cast all our cares upon you because you care for us. And right now, oh God, every individual right who have placed their hands up right now, they're saying, Lord, I need you. Lord, I can't do without you. Lord, I commit myself to you. Lord, I seek you as your word, that you will take care of me. And so, Father, Lord, we commit these lives to you right now in the name of Jesus. And we pray, oh God, Lord, that even as they surrender to you, Lord, that you will take charge and you will take control. For the one, oh God, who don't know you as Lord, and that one who is saying, Lord, come into my heart right now. Father, I pray that even as they invite you into their lives right now, oh God, Lord, that they will confess you as Lord and confess you as Savior right now. I pray, Father, Lord, that they will surrender to you, oh God, not only, oh God, that their life, but every decision that they make going forward, oh God, will be, oh God, a decision, oh God, that comes from the Holy Spirit. And so, Lord, as they surrender to you, Lord, we pray for blessing. We pray for direction. We pray for the peace that passeth all understanding to rest upon every life right now, oh God. Lord, those who are fearful, oh God, you have not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind right now, oh God. Those who don't know, oh God, what is going to happen tomorrow, Lord, you know, Lord. And so, Lord, we commit our days and we commit our situation and commit our circumstances to you right now, oh God. And we cast all our cares upon you because we know you are what? You are well able. You are well able to do more than we can think or even imagine. So right now, Lord, we thank you for every life. And for those, oh God, who did not put their hand up, Lord, but in their hearts of heart, they are wondering and they are worried and they are stressed out, oh God, we pray for calm and we pray for your peace, oh God. It was on the cross of Calvary that you died, oh God, for our peace. And even now, oh God, we thank you for your peace that is raining upon your people right now in Jesus' mighty name. And all of God's people say amen.
Provides.
Amen.
Do I worry about my life when you come to my rescue 1,000 times? Every other voice is a lie. God provides, God provides in ways I can't explain and can't deny. The little that I have, he multiplies. Just when I feel he won't show up on time, God provides. He'll come through. When the clouds of doubt rain down on you and test everything you thought you knew, what God can do for you. So tonight, close your eyes, there's no more need to fight. Watch God provide. God provides. It's hard to say when there's no food to eat.
Oh, yeah,
but what you see feels all that life will be. And will this be another year of misery for me? But my faith can't survive on just things I see.
Phone call.
Watch God provide.